Good afternoon, and welcome to A Little Midday Music at the Little Church Around the Corner. This is the last of our series of a celebration of American and European composers of African descent. We are very grateful to the MNT Foundation for their generous support of this series. Today we have a wonderful program of the music of George Walker. And before I tell you a little bit about George Walker, I just want to invite you to a very special performance here on June 10th at 7:30 p.m. It's the opera based on a medieval mystery play, Noah's Flood by Benjamin Bradham. It has a cast of thousands, and it's just a really wonderful piece that's rarely done. And it's, if you haven't seen it, come and see it. You will have a wonderful evening, I assure you. I'm going to just read a little bit about George Walker for you, because he's a name that we should know, but some of us don't. So yay for us for learning more about him today. George Walker was an American composer and organist, and the first African-American to win the Pulitzer Prize for Music, which he received for his work Lilacs. Walker was first exposed to music at the age of 5 when he began to play the piano. He was admitted to the Oberlin Conservatory at 14 and later to the Curtis Institute of Music to study piano with Rudolf Serkin, chamber music with William Primrose and George Piatigorsky, and composition with Scalero, the teacher of Samuel Barber. He received a doctorate from Eastman School of Music and taught at Rutgers in New Jersey for several years. He composed orchestral works, 5 sonatas for piano, a mass, cantatas, many songs, choral works, basically for the gamut of the classical repertoire. He was the recipient of 6 honorary doctoral degrees. And his 2 sons are musicians also. Walker's music was influenced by a wide variety of musical styles, including jazz, folk songs, and church hymns, as well as classical music. Unwilling to conform to the specific style, Walker drew from his diverse knowledge of previous music to create something that he could call his own. While a work such as Spatials, which we're going to hear today, uses 12-tone serial techniques, Walker could also compose in the style of popular music, such as his song Leaving. According to Mickey Terry, there's also Old Black Spirituals can be found in his violin sonata. I think this is going to be a fascinating program, and we are quite honored to have the distinguished pianist Benjamin Bradham here to play these works for us. So without further ado, let us welcome Benjamin.
Thank you.
I'm just going to tell you a little bit about the piano sonata number two. This next sonata contains changing meters, syncopation, and bitonal writing, which will all present great challenge for the performer to overcome. So do notice I said bitonal. This is not 12 tones, so it's a different harmonic language. So we'll just give Ben a moment. I don't know if you realize he's playing all of this music from memory. So that's quite something. then takes another well-deserved break. I just wanted to tell you what a wonderful experience for me personally this has been, these last six concerts. We've focused on the music of Joseph Bologna, George Bridgetower, Scott Joplin, Samuel Coleridge Taylor. Last week we did Florence Price and Margaret Bonds, and today George Walker. And I have to just be quite frank with you all, I was not aware of most of this music, and I'm just so excited to learn about it, and I think it's really expanded my horizons, and I hope it's expanded yours. Same thing, we did last season, we did the music of women composers. Same thing. I mean, I think we really, there's such an incredible treasure of music out there that we need to explore. And it tells us about history, and it tells us about our present moment, too, right? It's just so deep, it's so rich. So we'll give it another minute for Ben. And thank you for being here today. And we hope to see you next season.